If you are either a 3D student opening Blender for the first time, or an experienced user coming from a different 3D software like 3ds Max, Modo or Maya, you have probably seen this red and white circle on the Blender viewport and thought, what the heck is that and how can I use it? That circle is the 3D cursor, and it's one of those unique Blender features that at first glance doesn't look like much, but has a lot of interesting uses. The most basic being that the 3D cursor is the point where all new elements added to the scene will appear, but it can also be used as a temporal pivot point for one or more objects, or even as an assistant to some modeling tools, like Spin or Bend. On every new Blender project, the 3D cursor will appear on the world origin, and there are different ways to move it from there. The most useful, in my opinion, is the 3D cursor snapping menu that appears with the Shift S hotkey. It offers a lot of options, but the ones I use the most are Cursor to Selection, Cursor to World Origin, and Selection to Cursor. Cursor to Selection moves the 3D cursor to any selected element or mesh pivot point, with the exact same coordinate. If you are on edit mode, you can select any vertex to move the 3D cursor to that exact point. If you select multiple vertices, an edge, or a face, the 3D cursor will move to the median point between all the selected sub-elements. If you want to reset the 3D cursor position, using the Cursor to World Origin option will reset all the position values to zero. Then, I can use the Selection to Cursor command to move any element to the 3D cursor. This is very useful when moving entire objects in a very precise way, but not that useful to move geometry in edit mode, because if we use it with multiple geometry, it will make that geometry to overlap on the 3D cursor coordinates, and could lead to the typical problems that come with overlapping geometry. After explaining the radial 3D cursor menu, a different way to move the 3D cursor is its dedicated tool, found on the Tools panel, or the faster way to use it, the Shift plus right mouse button hotkey. This way to move the 3D cursor isn't very precise, but has a very interesting property which causes the 3D cursor to snap on surface and rotate depending on the face normal. And this is very interesting for some options and techniques that we will talk about a bit later. For now, the last option to move the 3D cursor is showing the right tools panel with the end key and coming to the view settings. There's a submenu for the 3D cursor where I can input very precise values on both location and rotation. It's a bit slow, but still useful when it comes to move the 3D cursor in just an axis or reset some values to zero. After explaining how to move the 3D cursor, let's see the most common uses for it. The most basic is, as you already know, when I add a new object to the scene, it will always spawn on the 3D cursor. Knowing this, aligning new created objects is very fast and easy. Also, if you remember, before I mentioned that using Shift plus right mouse button to move the 3D cursor over a mesh will align the rotation to the geometry. This is useful to create new geometry that shares the rotation of a specific face, but I need to indicate that I want the new mesh to align to the 3D cursor on the add-in options. This could be changed and made the option the default one on the Blender properties, but at least in my opinion I prefer to not change anything. Okay, now let's talk about origins. The 3D cursor is very important while trying to modify your mesh origin. With the Shift S menu I showed before, it's very easy to move the 3D cursor to the exact point you want the mesh origin, and then right-click the object and go to Set Origin, Origin to 3D Cursor. There are other ways to change the mesh origin, but this is one of the fastest and most precise in my opinion. Another option is to use the 3D cursor as a temporal pivot point. Among the different options showed on the top Transform Pivot Point menu is 3D cursor, and while that option is selected, the 3D cursor will be the pivot point for all transforms. This also could be done with an empty and active element option, but using the 3D cursor is a lot faster. This setting can also be useful while modeling. A common situation I mentioned on my recent mirror modifier tutorial, I leave a link on the comments and description below, is when you have to create a circular shape in the mirror middle point. If I try to scale the circle with any other pivot point transform, the circle will deform, having to create it again. But if I move the 3D cursor between these two vertices and scale using that point as pivot point, the circle gets scaled down without any problems. To end this video, the last use for the 3D cursor is as an assistant for some modeling tools. For example, while using the spin tool, the geometry will spin around the 3D cursor. Or moving to another example, when using the bend tool, which I access through the hotkey Shift W, the geometry will bend with the 3D cursor as pivot point. And that will be all for this video. Those were all the most important options and tools regarding the 3D cursor. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.